guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is a really interesting one because I'm gonna be doing a full face of makeup look using the Morphe X James Charles palette. So I got my hands on this palette a while ago and like it has been a couple of months and I remember doing this first impressions video using this palette. By the way, it's a mini palette and that's why it looks so small. I think this palette has been discontinued now. I'm not really sure, but I'm gonna leave the details, the links, everything in the description box below. So don't forget to check that out. So yeah, as I was saying, I remember doing a first impressions video and that video did really well on my channel. And so many of you guys were interested to know more about this palette and so many of you wanted to get your hands on this palette. So I thought why not give you guys some more information about this palette, and since this palette is just so versatile, I thought why not do a full face of makeup look using this palette. So obviously I saw James Charles doing this video on his channel first, and I've never seen an Indian girl doing this video. And why am I saying an Indian girl? Because the colors in the palette are same. But I really want to see if this palette is equally versatile for an Indian skin person also. So that's what we're gonna test today. Before we begin with the video, if you guys haven't subscribed to my channel already, then please don't forget to hit that subscribe button and hit the bell icon besides it. Please subscribe for more beauty, fashion and lifestyle videos. And now let's get right into the video. So as you can see, I've already done my base makeup, and why did I do that is because this palette only has powder eyeshadows, so there's no way that it's gonna replace my foundation and my concealer. So I went ahead and did my base makeup beforehand, and I also used a loose powder to just slightly set my under eyes because my under eyes creases a lot, so I really had to do that. Now for all the powder products like banana powder, bronzing, blush, highlight, everything is gonna be from this palette. So let's get started. So firstly, I think I'm gonna start with my eyebrows. I'm gonna fill in my eyebrows first using a dark brown eyeshadow, and I'm using this eyeshadow called Benny, and this is how it looks like. It's this really dark brown eyeshadow, and I'm using my angled brush. It's been a while since I've filled my eyebrows with powder product. I used to do that a lot, I guess even last year, but then I started using my eyebrow pencil and I never went back. So this is how my eyebrows look like. I think they look pretty perfect. I really like how this eyeshadow worked for my eyebrows, and it's also nothing new for me. I used to do this a lot with my Modern Renaissance palette. So I really love how my eyebrows look like. Now moving on to contour. I usually don't contour my face, but today I'm gonna do that for you guys just to show you that you can contour with this palette. So I'm gonna use the shade right on top of Benny. There's T, and this is like a very cool toned brown eyeshadow, and it looks really dark, so I'm not sure if I don't want it to look very muddy and patchy on my face. So I'm just gonna take a nice fluffy brush, and this is what I'm gonna use for contour. By the way, I just realized that the pan is so tiny that it's gonna be a task to fit this brush inside this pan. Right now I'm just gonna pinch the brush a little bit and pick the eyeshadow, and oh my god, it is very very pigmented. And now I'm just gonna contour my face. I don't think it looks muddy at all. You guys tell me in the viewfinder also. I think it looks pretty good. I'm just gonna blend it with my powder brush. Yeah, it doesn't look muddy at all, but it doesn't even make a huge difference on my face. Now I'm gonna bronze my face, and for that I guess I'm gonna use a mix of these two brown shades that are in the middle row. I'm gonna tell you guys the name of these shades. So this shade is 10% off and this one is No Beans. I'm gonna lightly bronze my face. I'm using very little product because I really don't want my face to turn muddy. I think my face looks okay, like the rest of my face, but my forehead looks really weird because I think I applied way too much product. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this pointy brush and I'm gonna use this yellow eyeshadow. The name of this shadow is Tune, and I'm gonna pick this. It's like a nice banana sort of a color, and I'm gonna apply a little bit of this on my forehead just to brighten it up and just to cancel any of that muddiness on my forehead. I'm gonna use this under my eyes to brighten the center of my face. So definitely you can use that eyeshadow as a banana powder, and I think the purpose of that eyeshadow in this palette is for it to be a nice banana powder. It melts into the skin really nicely, leaves it very matte, and it just looks very smooth and beautiful. So that particular shade is my favorite till now, like for my face makeup. Now moving on to blush, I think this is gonna be very very tricky because I literally cannot see a nice blush shade for my skin tone in this palette. Everything is either too muted or either too bright that it cannot be used as a blush. So the only shade that I think would work for my skin tone is this peachy brown sort of a color, and the name of this shade is Mary. So I think this might look good as a blush, but I'm still not sure if it will show up on my face or not. So I'm just gonna pinch my blush brush and I'm gonna pick this color. I'm gonna apply this on the apples of my cheek. I think we have a winner there. I really, really like this shade on my cheeks. At first I thought that there's literally no blush shade for my cheeks, and like this one is just so perfect. This literally can be my new favorite matte blush from now on. This is how the blush looks like. I think I really really love this. The bronzer and contour was a little weird, like it didn't really look that great on my face, but I think the blush and the banana powder is just amazing. Even the highlighter is going to be amazing because I've already used this particular shade as a highlighter before. So I was talking about this particular shade. This is called Face and it's a great highlighter. It's a really nice champagne-y color. This is how it looks like. It is such a stunning shade. You guys can see it. Even as an eyeshadow and even as a highlighter, it is just very stunning. And it's also very blinding. I've used it a couple of times. I'm gonna highlight the high points of my face. Can you guys see that? It is so blinding. I really, really love this. Just to top it off, I'm gonna use the shade Ring Light. It's this really pale shimmery eyeshadow, and I think even this is gonna be a really great highlighter for the face. So I'm not gonna be using a lot of this eyeshadow, just a little bit right on the very like high points of my face. And yeah, it looks really great. Wow, that's such a stunning highlighter. Now for eyeshadow, I think I'm gonna do something very colorful. I'm gonna do something blue and purple. So first I'm using this really nice periwinkle shade, which is called Brother, and I'm taking this eyeshadow on my shader brush and I will be applying this all over my eyelid. To blend the color in, I guess I'm gonna use this color, which is Playground. It's a slightly, it matches my nail. So this is how the eye looks like. Now I'm gonna do the exact same thing on the other eye. Now moving on to my lower lash line, I'm gonna be using this light purple sort of an eyeshadow, and this is in the shade Single. I'm gonna pick this up on my same shader brush. Obviously I'm gonna clean it first, and then I'm just gonna smoke my lower lash line. Now for my inner corner and brow bone highlight, I'm gonna again use the shade Ring Light and I'm gonna highlight the inner corners of my eyes. Now I think only an eyeliner is missing. Since we cannot use a liquid eyeliner or any sort of eyeliner, I'm gonna be using the black eyeshadow in this palette. The name of this shadow is Spooky. By the way, this black eyeshadow is really really pigmented. It's very very black. I And now I'm just gonna go ahead and do my lashes, my lipstick, and I'll be right back. So this is the final makeup look using only James Charles palette. I'm gonna link all of the other products that I've used, like lipstick, mascara, foundation, everything, in the description box below. So don't forget to check that out. And yeah, I'm really in love with this look. I think the eyeshadow turned out to be so great, especially for like highlighters and blush. I think it's a great, great palette. Love the banana powder that I've used, and just love it for everything else except contour and bronzer. You can make it work, but it's just not my favorite. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching today's video, and I hope you found it helpful. If you guys have any questions, please let me know in the comment section below. I will try and reply to as many comments as I can. And also, if you found the video helpful, then please don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to my channel, and hit the bell icon besides it to get notified whenever I upload a new video. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!